Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Daniel Dynamite Dubois stops Nathan Gorman. And, you know, it's a very interesting fight. You know, Daniel Dubois came in and supposed to be the big, strong puncher. And Gorman was supposed to be the guy to outclass him and outbox him. He outboxed him, supposedly, in the amateurs when they fought previously, you know, in sparring sessions and things like that. So, you know, people were looking for this to be that type of event. You know, it'd be a long, drug-out fight where you expected Gorman to outbox Dubois, and what ended up happening was Dubois caught him early and often and hit him with a lot of power shots, wore him down. And you know, initially Daniel Dubois went, you know, a little bit power shot crazy. He dropped him in the second round. He settled in and settled down, and by the fifth round he completely stopped him. And the reason why he stopped him, if you look at it, he just simply established his jab. He simply looked to box more, and boxing more opened things up for him. Gorman never hit him with anything significant to get his respect. And when you're facing a power puncher, a guy with that much power, that much strength, you know, and have the power advantage over you, you need to hit him with something just to, at least to establish your respect. And he never got his respect established throughout the course of that fight. And that's why I feel like Gorman lost. Gorman wasn't able to outbox him because he wasn't able to get his respect. You know, the reason with Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder, you know, a lot of fanboys say that Tyson Fury has no power. He can't hurt anyone. Here's the problem. That's untrue. And this is why. Because Tyson Fury caught Wilder with some very good, clean, crisp shots that got Wilder's respect. That mean that Wilder couldn't just rush in at any point, in any moment that he felt like. Wilder had to respect Fury's counters. And this is the same thing with Daniel Dubois, you know, and Nathan Gorman. Gorman never hit him with anything to get Dubois' respect. So Dubois had nothing to fear. He came in at will. He came in early and he came in often. And he eventually got the stoppage. It was an excellent fight. You know, Dubois showed that he has a higher IQ than many people give him credit for. He's not just some puncher that comes in there looking for a knockout. His defense looked good. His timing looked good. His shot selection looked good. And I think he's ready for the next level of boxing in the heavyweight division. Daniel Dynamite Dubois is on the rise. But once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.